Saya
Yes. They ask you to be patient, to waiting for others for joining with our discussion today. Okay, Mr. Jaka, because we already late about 12 minutes from 1 p.m. So I think this is better we starting this study in general today while we're waiting for others. Yes. Okay, guys. Good afternoon and assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.
Yeah, today this afternoon we invite Professor Jaka Sriyana to meet us at the our general studium, yeah, related to our subject in managerial economics, yeah, and we will discuss in the sub of managerial economics, this is a market structure. Yeah, it is very important at the managerial economics to understanding about the market structure, because this is important when the manager in the process of decision making relative to the in what structure matter our product and service. Yeah, so Pak Jaka Sriyana here will told to us about what the market structure and what the strategy for the manager to be survive at the high competition relatively at the markets competitive and monopolistic market. Yeah, but it is not. But it is important also when oligopoly. What the strategy for oligopoly? Yeah, and also what the benefits of the monopoly markets? Yeah, especially for the monopolies, not for the others. Yes, I think the monopoly market it is very ideal for the monopolies, but not for others. Okay, right? Yeah. Okay, guys. Yeah. To make a vision our time today, and I think it is very important to all of you to understanding about the market structure. Yeah, to involve in the decision making. Managerial level, so please, yeah, yeah, prepare your ballpoint, prepare your paper to notice what the Pak Jaga Sriyana give us about the what the point important related to the market structure. Okay, guys, let's be starting this discussion. Today by basmalah together.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim.
Yeah, I think times is yours, Pak Joko. I give you 1 hour at first, then we continue with the discussion. Okay, monggo Pak Joko.
Okay, thank you. Matur nuwun Bu Lilis. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Alhamdulillah, bersyukurlah, la haula wala quwwata illa billah, Allahumma shalli ala Muhammad. Alhamdulillah, I'm happy to join this class, especially to meet with Bulidis and also all the students from IBEF, I think. It's from Department of Economics.
Not only from IBF student, Pak Jaga.
Sorry.
Not only from the IBF.
Oh, I see.
Also, we mix, yeah. We mix with the regular student because I teach at the management department for the regular
okay. classes. Okay. Yes, yeah. Okay. Thank you, cool it is. Yeah. Because the my first question is, I suppose that the participant in this class is more than 30 because I think this is my second guest lecture in OMY, the first with Pak Agus, but I think in this class is only less than 10 students, I think. Yeah. Oh. But now I'm happy to joining the class with more 30 students, yeah, exactly 34 maybe. And I think that's possible to have more students. And also thank you for the opportunity to share. I think this is a good academic program, yeah, in for example in the Department of Economic and also maybe in other department, management or accounting, to have a guest lecture. And it means that we share, yeah, and they share different experience maybe among the lectures between in different university. We also have activities or test lecture like this, and hopefully that maybe we will invite also our colleagues from UMY, including also Bu Lilis and others. Thank you, Bu Lilis.
Alhamdulillah, yes. You're welcome, Pak Jaka.
Okay, guys, and all the participants in this class. Yes, as Bu Lilis mentioned that in this class about the managerial economics, yeah, the subject is managerial economics. And I'm sorry that maybe I will share mostly the theory and also some of the material is maybe we also can discuss the practice or the experience, and I'm sure also that we have you and me and also all the students have an experience, yeah, regarding the for example the activities in our life and in the transaction in many places, yeah, for example buying and selling other lands. And managerial economics, I think, closely related with the microeconomics, yes, the basic rule of the managerial economics and is microeconomics, and also we can, for example, extend the material with other strategies, for example, or maybe policy, getting the pricing, advertising, and others. But I'm sorry that I also believe that I take the material from many sources, book or others. Yeah, so this is not pure my original, for example, a paper. Yeah, but this I will share the PowerPoint for, I hope, 1 hour, about 1 hour, and we will make a discussion. Okay, this is the title. I choose the title, Market Structures and the Business Competition, but yeah, mostly based on the theory. Market structures, yeah, so we will start with the market. And I hope, I am sure that all of you are familiar with this term, markets. Yeah, and we discuss the market in economics. Yeah, this may be different if we discuss in the management perspective, because the markets, market structures is part of the markets, I think. Yeah, okay, if we read the books or maybe article or paper, maybe we can define in many definition. Yeah, what is the market? Yeah, for example, in the short term, in the brief definitions, market is the exchange where the buyer and sellers meet, or not only meet, but buyer and sellers meet, exchange, yeah, goods and services. And this is affected by some level of competition, yeah, actually. So so for example, the market may be in one specific place, yeah, this is not exactly true, yeah, or it doesn't, but this is just a theory. Yeah, some books maybe also mention that markets related to the place, and also the market related to the situation. This is only the theory, but in the most important is that the market is the media, maybe a media, the instrument, the situation, the opportunity that the sellers and can meet with the buyers, and they make transactions, they make an exchange, yeah, for goods and services. So this is the fundamental activities in our economy. Yeah. Okay. So market structure is this more definition in about the market. Yeah. As if we use, for example, the templates or point at which buyer and sellers negotiate their exchange, because it needs negotiation. Yeah, among the buyer and sellers, they make a agreement. Yeah, and others. Market is also an place where the seller of a particular good and services meet with the buyers, yeah, and that goods and services where there potential to transact takes place, yeah. And in short, I think as I mentioned, yeah, that the market is the situation, the condition, buyers and sellers meet each other. Okay, this is theoretically chart of market classification, yeah. For example, based on the place, time, competition. Yeah, actually, place, maybe now we have a virtual market and others, but we can also see that the actors, yeah, the sellers and buyers, it can be among the local sellers and buyers, national local and buyers, international local and buyers, between one and other countries, and also based on time, for example, this, it can be short, yeah, period, and the long and very long and others. And the third aspect of the market, for example, based on the competition, I think this, the competition level, yeah, in the market, for example. In short, we have two kinds of the competition. Yeah, because as I mentioned in the title, that the market structure and business competition. I think this is two terms that are very, very closely related here. The market structure will affect the competitions. The competition also will influence the market structure, and especially in the dynamic process. Yeah. For example, we can classify into two kind of the competition, imperfect and perfect. Yeah. Imperfect competition, there are monopoly, duopoly, oligopoly, and monopolistic competition. Yeah. And I think you also hear maybe in the first semester or the second semester in your course and the subject, especially in the subject of introduction to economic, for example, maybe your lecturer also told you about the perfect competition, pasar persaingan semurah in Indonesian term, for example, that we hear. Okay, market on the basis of competition. I think this is very important. As I mentioned, perfect and imperfect, and then perfect competitions here. The market where there exist large number of sellers and private perfect competition. I think in our life, our activities every day, we can see what kind of the product, the commodity, or the services that include in the perfect competition. And imperfect, we can also divide, classify into monopoly, duopoly, and oligopoly, monopolistic. Let's we continue with next. We will discuss one by one of all the market structure. The perfect competition, for example, sometime in the in Indonesian terms, the many books say that mention, the authors mention about the perfect competition as pasar persaingan sempurna. But I think that is only the theory. The perfect competition is only the how the perfect of the competition. Yeah, but I think this is better that we understand. Yeah, we classify or we have an opinion, that the perfect competition at the market structure with a very high competition, very high competition. Yeah, this is the condition. For example, at least five condition of the perfect competition: large number of and small firm, for example, usually that's small firm, but large number. Yeah, you can see many examples in our, and where the place or location in your life, for example, in your city and others. This small firm. And buyer and sellers is identical, for example, no product difference, Almost unlimited. For example, that suppliers cannot set their price. No barriers to entry or to exit. And most important is that the sellers, especially, is a price taker. Yeah, it's been that the sellers don't have a power to set the price. This is actually is very important in the economy, because, for example, if we discuss the very popular terms, for example, liberalization. What is liberalization? The consequence. The consequence of liberalization in our economy is especially actually liberalization has many aspects. For example, the asset, the owners, and also the price. Liberalization means that in the economy, in this economy, the price is set by markets. That is the competition. Because of competition, not monopoly, not oligopoly, monopolistic or others. So maybe we say that generally speaking, the many commodity, yeah, we can take some examples to give an example about the in our country, in your city and others for the perfect competition. Okay, so market power, why? We will discuss the theoretical first, and then maybe we will have a discussion about the implication of the strategy as the perfect competition. The perfect competition, as I mentioned, that the sellers does not have a market power, no market power, no ability to. So what's the consequence? Maybe the price is low, and then the profit is limited, and then the, for example, the advantage, lower advantage, and others, because this, and usually this is the small firm, small size. This theoretically, for example, the implication of the competition means perfect competition. For example, the price is flat. Yeah, if you see it's flat in the one level, for example, $40 for one commodity, for example, and in the market there is the supply and the interaction between supply and demand in as an equilibrium. Yeah, market equilibrium. This in the implication in the market. And what's more important, that the dynamic change of the profit. For example, that we can say that the blue area is the profit. Yeah, the profit, because per unit, and the total is the profit of the firm. Yeah, price minus average cost. For example, this is average cost. This is the price, and then next, what is the dynamization of the situation in the market? It can be changed, dynamically changed, yeah, in the market condition based on the price or cost, yeah, price or cost. But we know that the price is, I think because this depends on the market decision, not a seller decision, and the situation also dynamic. So maybe change is in the cost. Yeah, finally, because this, then for example, this situation, for example, when the average cost is more than price, this is loss for the sellers. Yeah, because of the impact of the competition. Yeah. As the result of the dynamic competition, we know this is the situation in the long run. What is this very important for the economy, not only for the firm, but for the economy. For the economy, effort cost equal with price. This in the long run. We hope this is the best situation. Or maybe we can say that this in the market efficiency and economic also in the efficiency. And I hear, yeah, I remember in the very popular term, where the average cost equal with the price, because this is the price, the horizontal line is price, this is the average cost. When this is the mid in the one point, we can mention this point as the beauty of price mechanism. The beauty of price mechanism. Yeah, in Indonesia, for example, the indahnya persaingan. Yeah. The beauty of price mechanism. Why? This is the beauty. Why? This is beautiful. Yeah, beautiful for the economy, because it causes an efficiency. There is no equity between seller and buyers. Yeah, this is the competition. This is why liberalization is not only but concept, but liberalization is paradigm. Yeah, paradigm in the economy. Not only paradigm, but school of thought. So school of thought, classical, for example, liberalization. Yeah. This because of the concept, the idea of the competition, efficiency. Okay, this first of the our price, market structure. How about next, monopolistic competition? And the name is monopolistic competition, yeah. But this near, yeah. Although the name is monopolistic, but I think this structures near with perfect competition. Actually, this high or moderate, yeah, high monopolistic competition. We can say that the monopolistic competition actually is the sellers place or sell their product or services in the competitive market, in the perfect competitive market, in the high competitive. Because of the, for example, in the competitive market, there's low profit, maybe a low market share. So they try to make an innovation. Yeah, they make a, they create a, something new for their product, for example. Or in the short term, on the brief explanation, you can say that the sellers, one or two sellers, will create a differentiation. Yeah, differentiation. So there's next, and then they will sell in the different market with the competition. Not only one sellers that make differentiation, but many, maybe some sellers or several sellers. So in the new market competition, in the new market structure, we can say as a monopolistic. Yeah. Monopolistic is to differentiate. This is why, for example, yeah, we can say the some products, yeah, about the market in the this market structure, right, for example. So for example, if you next you graduate from the, for example, the university, and then you join with the private company, for example, that maybe sell their product or services in the monopolistic competition, you must understand that the monopolistics come from differentiation. Yeah, there's many industry firm, for example, yeah, they make a different, they differentiate their product with some ways, for example, brand identity. I think this is very important. Brand identity means to maintain that their product is different with others. For example, the product software, for example, and others, example also, for example, we can say that they try to maintain. Yeah. Yeah, we, if we discuss the this differentiation, I think there's many aspects, yeah, because they can use, they will use, for example, advertisement, packaging, yeah. And, but we can classify into two strategies, actually, the manager, the sellers. The first is pricing strategy, the second is non-price strategy. Pricing strategy, for example, first, because the seller make a differentiation. So I think this is rational if they sell their product in higher price than in perfect competition. Yeah, higher price if we compare with the perfect competition. Yeah. The second, the non-price competition is, I think we can say that there's many aspects here. Many aspects from the non-price companies. How about the airplane, for example? This monopolistic, or it can be oligopoly, yeah. But other commodity, maybe can classify in the monopolistic. Next, what I will go to the in the difference, the key. Yeah, the key words or key aspect of the monopolistic is creating the differentiation of the product or services through non-price strategies. Okay, well, yeah, we have to. This is the example, yeah, example of the product or commodity in the monopolistic. This is the price. Try to be concerned with the theory, theoretically. In monopolistic, the seller can set the price higher than perfect competition. Yeah, we can say they will set the price at A. Yeah, more than average cost. If we compare with the preferred, where this point is the price in a competitive market. Why? Because marginal cost, this is marginal cost, is the supply curve. Yeah, I think this, if you have a question, what is the definition of supply curve? Supply curve is marginal cost above the average total cost. This is supply curve. So if this the demand, this supply, this is the point. This is the price at the perfect. Now, in fact, this is the A at A. A is higher than price. So this is the first benefit, the benefit of the monopolistic. This is in the short run, yeah, but in the long run, and then because many sellers, maybe other sellers also try to make a differentiation, also create something new, for example, so the competition will be higher. And yeah, I think more seller in the monopolistic. Finally, what is the impact? In the long run, the price, yeah, average, for example, the price will be same with the average cost. Right? It's also efficient, yeah. It's the indicator of the economy efficient, the market is efficient, but it is still more than the price in the perfect competition. Yeah, this company. Okay, this is the the conclusion of the monopolistic. Okay, there's some aspect, yeah, of the monopolistic. There's some strategies, maybe the monopolistic, the seller possible to make a merger or other strategy, yeah, acquisition and the management, yeah, for example, merger between two or more firm, yeah, it can be passive into three, for example, horizontal mean the same markets, they make they combine, they join, the merger, they merge, yeah, one, and also vertical, for example, buying a resource provider, for example, steel company and automaker and others and conglomerates, yeah, there's different business, yeah, and related industry. Okay, next. Okay, so the monopoly, sorry, the monopolistic is, it can be understood as a market structures, as a modification, yeah, as the evolution of the perfect competition. Next, how about the oligopoly? We know that oligopoly in the structures has a lower sellers. Yeah, there's only a few sellers, and usually this is the big size, yeah, big company. And so the oligopoly has more. Oligopolies has more market power to set the price. Yeah, to sell their product in the markets. Yeah. Usually they can control the market, yeah, the market share, especially. They can control the price, yeah. The competitions usually is lower than in monopolistic and also in competitive market, yeah. And exactly that, we can also understand that the product for among oligopolies is different, yeah, differentiated, yeah, because this is, for example, airplane, handphone, computer, laptop, and others. Yeah, this is we can classify into an oligopoly structure. Yeah, and this many strategy between oligopolies one and others, and we say that oligopolies at the simple oligopolies between two sellers, for example, that in textbook we can say as a duopoly between one and another. And this condition, yeah, some condition between oligopolies, yeah, sometimes maybe they make collusion, yeah, collusion or agreement among the oligopolies. So is it good or not for the economy? Yeah, if the collusions or agreement and then has an impact to the on the price, for example, and the price will be higher. Yeah, I think this is good for the economy. Yeah, because we can conclude that oligopolies will sell their product, yeah, is higher, yeah, than monopolistic or perfect competition. So, and then the consumer will buy the products at the higher price, very high price. So this is maybe, for example, the oligopoly contributes to the inflation, for example, to the inequality. If we see, yeah, if we as a macroeconomic perspective, yeah, this, for example. Yeah, the oligopolies, for example, it can be there's a price leader, one oligopoly as a leader in the market. They have an advantage as a leading enterprise, yeah, and the price is independent. And this many disadvantage for other firms, yeah, and also many impacts, yeah, negative impact in the economy. So, for example, high cost economy is also maybe as an impact of the many oligopolies or goods and services which are sold by oligopolies in high price. Yeah. Okay. Next, last of the market structure is monopoly. I think this easy for us to understand this term monopoly. Monopoly is single sellers, many buyers. Monopolies can sell their product, yeah, based on their price, yeah, they want. Yeah. So, yeah, but I think in our economy, we can classify the monopolies into two. For example, yeah, the first is the monopolies from the closely related to the government or government enterprise, or we can say BUMN, for example. And the private, yeah. I think it's difficult for us to find the pure monopolies in the private sector. It means the private company. But the monopolies in our country and also other countries may be closely related to the government owns, yeah. Because the government, for example, electricity, for example, gasoline and others, the government has a monopolies, yeah, in this market. Because the government has an objective, not only to sell a product to get the profit, no, but to serve, yeah, to provide a product or commodity or service in the market, so the consumer, the community, the people can buy this product, yeah, and also other reason, for example, there's a high, a huge investment, very expensive investment, yeah, it needs infrastructures, yeah. Expensive infrastructure and others, and also this is also political decision, for example. So mostly the monopoly in developing countries, for example, in other countries also this to fulfill the to meet with the government mission, yeah, to provide commodity goods and services for the economy, yeah. Yeah, but we also can find the monopolies, for example, we know in the computer, yeah, Intel and others as a monopolies, yeah. In the local, for example, in the local aspect, in the local area, for example. We can also find the monopolies, for example, PCIM in Indonesia and around Indonesia. And so there's also monopolies in the certain market, yeah, for example. Theoretically, the monopolies set the price based on the, we say as a markup, yeah, markup mean, it means that the price is higher than the price in the other structure. Yeah, in the oligopoly, monopolistic, and also perfect competition. Yeah, so this the I think the term that can explain how big the markup. Yeah, how big the firm can earn their revenue, their profit. Yeah, because of the monopolies. And I think many countries has an act, yeah, to prohibit the monopolies, yeah. Okay. Yes, yes, but this many some what kind of monopolies, yeah, naturally monopolies or maybe because of the natural resources, because of the technology, yeah, because of the geographic aspect, yeah, it must be monopoly to make efficient, for example, yeah. This, for example, if a person to sell their water in the desert, for example, yeah, I think this is possible to many people, yeah, many sellers, yeah, but this only one, for example. Because technological, the patent, yeah, it can, I think this is a fair, for example, yeah, fair for the own, inventor, for example, because their invention, their technology, and then they can create something new, new technology, for example, and then they will sell the product, for example, in the military, in the weapon, in the other aspect, yeah, high technology, yeah, and then some the seller will be a monopolist in the country. Yeah, I think this to appreciate this, and also yeah, government monopoly that I just mentioned. Yeah, okay, I think this is theoretically the monopolies. I'll go to, because it's almost, yeah, almost 1 hour. Okay, we go to the conclusion and the market structures. This is our conclusion that firms operating in perfectly competitive market take the market price as given, yeah, given. Produce output where price equal with marginal cost. And also, this is the short term. In the long run, price equal with effort cost, long run effort cost. This is the indicator of the efficiency of the economy. And firm may earn a profit, yeah, almost in the short run. The normal profit. Try to remember that a perfect competition will earn the normal profit. What is the definition of the normal? The normal, yeah, I think the maybe this is the average, yeah, the average. We cannot mention, we can say, explain how much percent, for example, but the profit, yeah. But this is the normal, yeah, the average based on the markets, the limited. This is why the economy then can be said as an efficient, yeah, because with the normal profit, the sellers will sell their product as close as or near the effort cost. Yeah. It means the consumer will buy the product also almost the effort cost. So there's no extra profit for the seller. No extra profit, no extra money, no extra revenue for the company, for the stockholder. Yeah, it means that it will create an equity in the economy. Yeah, in the macro aspect. Yeah, not inequality. Yeah, so this is why some countries, for example, I hear the several countries in the Singapore, in the ASEAN countries, for example, also has an act, yeah, to set some commodities, yeah, in the economy. For example, Malaysia has also still maintain to set the price of some commodity in the country, for example, is to avoid inequality, to avoid high or extra profit for sellers, to protect the poor people. Yeah, this policy. Yeah. Okay, and then monopoly. Yeah, in contrast, yeah, they will get a much monopoly profit. Yeah, high profit. And monopolistic oligopoly has also higher profit. Yeah. Higher profit than perfect, maybe lower profit than monopoly. So, in short, my conclusion is, in the micro perspective, will affect the macro perspective through the market structure. This was the second. The strategies, for example, if we assume that we are or you as a seller, as a manager, yeah. To make the strategies. What is the kind of the market strategies and optimum? Yeah, optimum. It will give the sellers, give the manager high profit. This an oligopoly or monopolistic. Yeah, but I think this more rational in monopolistic because monopolistic is. I think this is free for us to. Create, yeah, to make an innovation. But in oligopoly, usually this a very very big company, yeah, multinational or international, yeah. For example, if you then snag 1 or 2 years graduates from the university, you can make a new unit of the business, yeah. For example, some new business or startup and others, and. Maybe try to enter the market with the monopolistic competition, for example. Yeah, this is my conclusion, Bu Lilis. Thank you, and maybe I hope there is a discussion. We will have a question and answer, or maybe a discussion between the audience. Thank you, Bu Lilis.
Okay, thank you, Pak Jaka Sriyana. Yes, let's we continue with discussion related to the material explained by Pak Jaka Sriyana. Okay, Pak Jaka, I will starting with my question and I mean I will provoke my student to continue the others question to you, right? Yeah. Okay, Pak Jaka. Sometimes we confuse between perfect competition and monopolistic. For example, does traditional markets usually reflect the competitive market? Because at the traditional markets, yeah, there are many sellers and also buyers, and every single sellers. Cannot control the price because the price determined by bargaining between sellers and buyers. For example, when we go to Pasar Beringharjo, for example, we will buy some clothes of batik, for example. There are many sellers of batik over there and also many buyers of batik over there. And every seller offering the price, yes. But finally, the price is resulting by bargaining between me and the sellers, right, Pak Jaka?
And the
sellers of batik only as a price taker. Yeah, does the market traditional usually reflect the market competition? Because many buyers and sellers and also every single sellers over there couldn't control the price. But when this batik then go to the Mirota batik, for example, the Mirota batik, yeah, the customer only as a price taker over there, yeah. So this is the different market for the batik product. Yeah, this is my question. Does the traditional market usually reflect the competitive market because price determined by bargain between sellers and buyers, and the sellers here only as a price taker. But when this batik when
in we Margaria, go
to the, yeah in Margaria at the same as the product, yeah, we only as a price taker as a customer. So okay. Please explaining about this to make understanding for the student. Yeah.
Okay. Thank you. Your provocation.
I will provoke. Yeah,
I'm waiting the. Maybe student to address the question, also to give your opinion, or maybe not the question is okay. For example, you given your experience, buying or maybe something or batik, for example, like Lilis mentioned. Okay, Lilis, for example, the batik. I understand that the batik naturally is the different product. We can classify the batik market into at least two kinds of the market structure. The first is monopolistic, the second oligopoly. But oligopoly, I think this we cannot classify the batik the oligopoly. But I understand that I agree that batik is a part of the monopolistic competition. Yeah, monopolistic competition become this different one and others. It has attribute, for example, batik from Pekalongan, batik Margaria, batik Danarati and others. Okay, and the second, in the one market competition, for example, monopolistic, there is the segmentation, right? There's different segments. For example, a high price and moderate or middle, and then the low price. Batik with low price batik usually sold in the traditional markets, and the final price is based on the hard negotiation. The strong negotiation.
But sometimes this is the same product. We go to Birota Batik, we just as a price taker over there.
We couldn't
put the gain anymore.
Because the buyers usually not only pay one or two. With low price, 100,000 for example. But that is different with the batik with 500,000 per unit, for example, and also different with the 2 million, for example. But if we go to Danarhati, we go to Soga, for example, there is one that we can not negotiate. This is purely that the seller will set the price. But in the low price, the price decision, the final price is based on the negotiation. We should have a skill to
skill for bargaining.
with the seller.
And
you have an experience,
every customer
for example,
have the different skill for bargaining.
When you have
the
a tip,
price,
for example,
and other. So the conclusion, batik is one of the type of monopolistic market.
Monopolistic,
right?
Because on the product,
But sometimes we confuse with a different place when at the
different segment, for example.
No. If the different place we buy something, when we buy batik at the Beringharjo, we can bargain with the sellers. Yeah. But not when we go to Mirota Batik and Margaria and so on, I think when batik at the Beringharjo, the type of market structure is a perfect market structure.
A perfect market structure is like, for example, what is the Figura market? Figura, Bulilis Figura near Gajah Mada.
Yes.
If we count, there's more than 20 or 40 sellers. 2027, yeah, but with
there
the similar,
are many
yeah,
up there. Yeah,
yeah, very
and
similar.
And we can bargain for the price.
Yeah,
we can bargaining for the price for the figura. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, Pak. For example, one, agriculture product usually at the perfect market.
Yes, yeah,
because identical and also have the perfectly substitutes each others. Yeah, yeah. But when we buy at the for example Transmart, yeah. I think this is not as a perfect market anymore because the customer have to be price taker over there.
The seller or the customer?
The customer.
The
price
customer.
Taker.
Price the, taker. Yes, yes.
At the,
yeah,
at
price
the
taker,
for example.
Yeah.
For the same product, for example, bayam, kangkung, and
yeah,
and so on.
Yeah.
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 We understand that one type of competitive market is agriculture market, agriculture product, because the very identical and perfectly substitutes. Yeah. But I also confused with this product. Then we buy at the supermarket, at the Transmart, at the Carrefour, and so on. Yeah, because we couldn't make the bargaining to agree at the certain price because the price determined by the seller. So,
okay.
What you can explain to the student for this case?
Yes, this is the aspect of the place. That's like the place, yeah. That's like the same product. The same company, different price. There's different price. For example, if we buy the roti O, or we buy a KFC in the airport, this different. We buy bakso, for example, in airport, this very expensive. Yeah, because the meaning of it. So we still, especially me, I still believe that the place still play an important role in the market. Yeah, so the market will be affected. There will be influence not only the tangible aspect on the price, but also place. Yeah, so actually the seller will sell the same product with the different place or a different package, for example, a better package, yeah, better situation and others. And maybe Bu Liris also, for example, read the history of Starbucks coffee. Yeah, yeah. If we read the history of the Starbucks coffee, actually, they sell not the coffee, actually, but the place and the package and the brand, yeah, brand.
Yes.
Yeah, this. Why? Yeah, this one of the creativity, yeah, the innovation of the sellers, yeah. And now, for example, in Yogyakarta, many culinary actually they sell not the product, but they sell the price, they sell the situation, they sell the time, yeah.
Not delicious at the product, not delicious at the culinary product,
yeah,
right? But also a good views.
Yeah, yeah, like good views. For example, gudeg. Why we Bu Liris here the gudeg Mawon that they open at the 1 midnight, starting midnight.
Yes, at the Tahunan, right?
Yeah, one in the midnight at 1 until subuh. But then they never sell gudeg before this time. Why? Because they sell the product based on the time, for example. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay. So yeah. So what condition that determine the market structure? It is only the number of sellers and buyer, or the power of the sellers to determine the price.
Yeah, because we still concerned with old theory,
the traditional old theory.
Actually, we need to write, we need to write a microeconomic and managerial economic in the different aspect that may be similar or maybe meet with the situation now. for example, that how customer, for example, see how customer understand the value of the product, not only the, for example, tangible aspect of the product, but the situation, the time, the place, and others. Yeah, and also how the manager can create the new market. Yeah, create the new markets, not only depend on the characteristic of the customer or the consumer. Okay.
Yeah. Yeah, so create the new market, it means that create the new demand, right?
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah. Maybe Bu Lilis, how many Bu Lilis come to the Jejamuran?
More than 10.
Yeah, I think more than 10. And you, I hope, I'm sure that Lilis want to go there again.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, Pak Jaka.
Yeah, maybe Bu Lilis also want to go to Jamuran again next time.
Right. Yeah. This restaurant serving the customer with the healthy food, right? Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
With the healthy food, with hygienist food, yeah.
And my house is only 2 kilometers. My house is only 2 kilometers from the Jamuran.
Oh yeah,
and I think
this is the
yeah, I know the history of the Jejamuran. Yeah, the starting and the business. Yeah, Pak Ratijo, starting with the very small, warung, warung until now. This and the local market, we can classify Pak Jejamuran as monopoly, right?
Yeah,
and
yeah,
they can maintain the taste.
Yeah, this is very good and serve the health. I think this the specific message from the Jejamuran is a healthy food. I
reckon. Yes,
I think that. So that's why there are many buyers go over there to eat the food created by the Jejamuran. And there are many menu that create from the mushroom. And there are many kind of mushroom planting over there, and then by the good chef we can enjoy the many menu from the mushroom. Mm. Right, yeah, this is a satay of mushroom, gulai
yeah.
mushroom.
Yeah.
Yeah. And also
okay, this student we invite.
Yeah, okay.
You,
yeah, I think all the student already provoked by Bu Lilis. Okay, please you tell something at the experience related to the market tracker, or will ask to Pak Jaka. Okay. Okay, student, time is yours. Yeah, please. I think the student can use the bahasa Indonesia, Pak Jaka.
Yeah, okay, no problem. Okay. Bahasa Indonesia or Chinese, no problem. Or
oh,
Arabic.
Yeah? Arabic.
Arabic, okay.
I couldn't
but
understand.
But Bu Lilis should translate first. Use Arabic.
I couldn't understand about the Arabic. Okay, silakan mahasiswa, if you want to ask related to the market structure to Pak Jaka, you can use bahasa Indonesia. Yuk. Hello.
71 students.
Yes. Okay, this is a special moment that we can meet with Pak Jaka to discuss related to the market structure that will bring to the decision making process at the level of management. Yeah. Halo mahasiswa, ya silakan kalau mau bertanya nggak usah pakai bahasa Inggris. Bahkan kalau bisa bahasa Cina, Pak Jaka mempersilahkan ya. But not for Arabic, because Bu Lilis couldn't translate to Indonesian or English. Okay, saya tunjuk ya. Kalau gitu ya Pak Jaka, saya tunjuk aja ya Pak Jaka ya.
Oke,
biar banyak yang apa namanya nih. Bentar dulu. Oke. Okay, baby Angela. Hello, baby. Hello, Beb. Baby Angela. Beb. Hello, Beb. Wah, ini malah ini ditinggal lungo ini Pak Ajakan ya.
Why no one certain turn on your video?
Only one student, that is a bully list here. Okay, Diva Lintang Azahra. Hello, Diva. You already connect with this discussion today? Ya kayak gini gitu ya. Okay, Clara Claudia. Yes, okay, Clara Claudia. Please, you will discuss with Pak Jaka related to the market structure. Yeah. Please, maybe you have the special questions for the Prof. Jaka Sriyana. Time for yours. Yeah. Pakai bahasa Indonesia nggak apa-apa loh, Clara.
Iya.
Yeah.
Iya, yeah, Bu.
Okay.
Nah, kan sekarang kayak apa strategi ekonomi itu dari dulu sekarang itu berubah-ubah ya, Bu, tiap tahunnya. Pertanyaan saya gimana?
Tanyakan ke Pak Jaka ya, bukan ke
Bilis. Saya pengen bertanya, Pak. Perkenalkan nama saya Clara Claudia, saya dari Manajemen 19 okay. Universitas Muhammadiyah. Gimana caranya apa strategi marketing untuk menghadapi perubahan-perubahan zaman gitu? Strategi marketer.
Okay. Di marketing ya, oke.
Okay. Thank you. We should answer Pak Liris.
Yeah, what the marketing strategy the VUCA era? VUCA, yeah, volatile, uncertain, complexity, and also ambiguity. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, maybe your question is very good. Yeah, I appreciate your question about the idea of the marketing strategy, yeah, because for example the manager, yeah, especially the marketing manager should respond, should understand, yeah, the situation, yeah. To answer your question, maybe we can especially me, we use some perspective. For example, the first is theoretically theory.
I will ask to Clara. You want Pak Jaka explain with bahasa or English version, Clara? Hello, Clara.
Iya, Bu.
You want Pak Jaka explaining your question with bahasa Indonesia or English? Kamu ingin Pak Jaka menerangkan pakai bahasa Indonesia atau pakai bahasa Inggris?
Bahasa Inggris, bahasa Indonesia aja, Bu.
Biar. Oh, bahasa Indonesia, bahasa Pak Jaka. Oke, okay, yes. Biar ya, langsung masuk di hati, Pak.
Iya, terima kasih. Okay. Pertanyaannya bagus ya, tadi terkait yes. dengan strategi pemasaran. Ya. Ya. Kalau kita baca banyak beberapa teori, ya, baik ekonomi atau manajemen, itu kan pertama itu kita bisa pahami bicara sejarah, kan gitu ya. Sejarah tentang manajemen atau sejarah tentang pemasaran, sejarah tentang selera, ya, tentang psikologi, karena pasar itu aspeknya kan banyak ya, tidak hanya ekonomi ya, tapi juga aspek sosial, aspek psikologi, nah itu sehingga kemudian kalau ada pertanyaan terkait dengan bagaimana penjual atau manajer harus merespon, ya mestinya mengikuti itu. Misalkan sedikit saya bercerita, mungkin era 20 tahun yang lalu, mungkin banyak buku teks atau manajemen itu bercerita tentang bagaimana membuat sebuah produk yang baik. Ya, itu harus memenuhi, produk itu harus memenuhi selera konsumen. Makanya kalau di ekonomi mikro, misalkan permintaan itu fungsi selera, bukan selera. Nah, sehingga banyak perusahaan kemudian membuat produk, memasarkannya, mengikuti selera konsumen. Tapi kemudian berikutnya, 10 tahun berikutnya, tidak lagi dominan selera konsumen itu yang diikuti. Tetapi perusahaan itu menciptakan, mendesain selera konsumen. Mereka diiming-imingi gitu ya. Dibuat produk baru. Ya, sesuatu yang tidak pernah terbayangkan oleh konsumen dibuat oleh produsen. Ya, saya kira itu basisnya adalah temuan-temuan teknologi ya. Mungkin Anda, saya khususnya ya dulu tidak pernah membayangkan ya. Kemudian kalau kita bisa kuliah itu dengan model Zoom seperti ini kan, ya, tidak juga membayangkan bagaimana kemudian komunikasi antar orang, antar manusia itu demikian cepat karena adanya temuan teknologi. Nah, ini kan tentu kemudian itu teknologi itu diadopsi di berbagai produk. Maka produk-produk yang mengadopsi teknologi lah kemudian yang laku. Nah, itu kan strategi pemasaran juga. Nah, ini banyak sekali. Nah, kemudian berikutnya lagi era sekarang, kemudian era-era akhir ini adalah era tentang efisiensi dan ramah lingkungan. Maka produk-produk yang ramah lingkungan, selain juga tetap mempertahankan teknologi, nah itu yang laku. Makanya kita mengenal yang namanya low-cost green car. Ya, low-cost green car. Mobil-mobil yang biaya murah, tapi green, ya, ramah lingkungan. Nah, itu ternyata yang kemudian dibuat ya, strategi oleh manajer ya, ketika mereka menjual produk-produknya, itulah yang laku. Ya. Sebagian besar ya, tentu mobil yang lain juga lebih laku. Nah, kemudian tentu itu pun dipengaruhi oleh situasi konsumen. Selain low-cost green car, ada penerbangan murah ya, low-cost carrier misalkan gitu ya. Makanya kita tahu ya ada maskapai yang sangat murah ya, misalkan Lion Air, kemudian juga maskapai-maskapai yang lain ya. Ya, tapi tentu kemudian maskapai yang mahal itu kemudian tidak laku juga enggak juga kan, karena mereka punya segmen pasar yang berbeda. Jadi contoh tadi juga ketika saya ceritakan bagaimana kemudian lahirnya makanan, minuman, Starbucks itu lahirnya adalah mereka ingin menjual kopi dalam bentuk situasi yang lain ya. Malah lebih mahal, tapi laku kan gitu dengan berbagai variasi. Jadi kata kunci dari pemasaran itu sepertinya ya kreativitas, ya kreatif, kreasi, inovasi. Maka kata kuncinya adalah invention and innovation. Itu terus saja dilakukan ya, baik dari aspek teknologi, dari aspek produk, dari aspek lingkungan yang ramah, dan itu tentu harus membawa pada harga yang lebih murah ya sebisa mungkin, karena itu efisiensi ya. Jadi kita mungkin tetap akan bercita-cita ya satu saat nanti bagaimana misalkan kita tidak perlu lagi pakai betul-betul wireless itu tanpa kabel itu akan menjangkau semua aspek ya misalkan gitu. Itu satu bentuk pasar baru mungkin ya, energi misalkan. Mungkin Mbak Clara membayangkan nggak kira-kira bahwa pom bensin itu kira-kira 10 tahun yang akan datang, mungkin tidak akan ada lagi separuhnya, dugaan saya. Kenapa? Sekarang sudah ada inovasi mobil listrik. Ya, salah satu negara di Eropa, yaitu malah saya sebut adalah Israel itu sudah punya undang-undang tahun 2030 tidak boleh ada lagi mobil berbahan baku fosil di negara itu. Di beberapa Eropa sudah inovasi. Saya kira di Indonesia pasti akan ikut. Ya ini kan berarti pom bensin, minyak, bahan bakar itu kemudian tidak laku bukan karena bahannya nggak ada. Ketika dulu kita khawatir bahan ini fosil nanti tidak ada lagi bumi, ternyata itu diatasi dengan teknologi ya, tidak akan ada lagi saya kira itu pom bensin seperti kita sekarang ini, karena nanti akan berganti dengan tempat pengisian bahan bakar khususnya untuk listrik, dari listrik.
Nah, ini charging di mana-mana ya Pak?
Ya charging di mana-mana. Jadi mungkin nanti setiap lewat jalan itu kita tahu stasiun-stasiun kecil-kecil untuk kendaraan kita ya. Mungkin kita belum terbayangkan hal seperti itu ya. Itu salah satu contoh saja saya kira. Nah, inilah kata kunci dari ini ya, strategi-strategi yang terkait dengan teknologi dan temuan-temuan yang lain. Saya kira gitu ya, Bu Lilis nggih, matur nuwun.
Ya, matur nuwun Pak Jaka. Oke, thank you very much. For Clara, related to your question, it is a good question. Yeah, the key for the marketing strategy is kreatif, ya, Pak, ya. The keyword of the marketing strategy in this situation is innovation and invention, ya. Because marketing not only how sell the product, but also we have to understanding about the taste, about the social and also culture and also character. Pak Jaka, I want to ask to you related to the Clara questions. Yeah, you said that the next maybe there is no fuel power in Indonesia and also in other country because the preference of the people to use electricity, yeah, use electricity for the transportation, yeah, and so there are many charging point in the streets, yeah, to recharge our apa ya aki itu ya apa sih namanya baterai our battery. But the question is how to produce electricity itself? Does it still using the fossil energy, Pak Jaka?
Yeah, but I hear that the material is smaller. Yeah, and smaller. For example, yeah, there's lithium, aluminium. Yeah, this although this is still the material, yeah, from the natural resources, especially for the mining, yeah. But this is not a mining process like gasoline, yeah, petroleum, that it needs a big or very expensive investment, yeah. But it is cheaper the process and efficiency. For example, yeah, nuclear power, or maybe next, maybe I guess, yeah, maybe, or I hope the evolution of the new energy is based on the naturals, not like natural resources, but for example, solar cell, and also others, for example, water and others, yeah, that it's in fact, maybe the one in one, for example, equipment, for example, can shift or maintain the energy in the very long time, yeah, long period. So it means that we use one equipment from, for example, battery lithium, yeah, for example, if it's long, maybe more than 10 or 20 years, for example. So that's very efficient, yeah, based on the natural resources.
Yes. Okay. I invite for other student to ask for the Pak Jaka. Okay. The first is lady. Now I invite for the boy. Okay. Muhammad Alif. Okay. You still join with this class, Muhammad Alif? Hello.
Hello. Yes.
Okay. Yes. Yeah. Maybe you have the a specific question for the Pak Jaka. Please, time yours.
Okay, I want to ask to Mr. Jaka
about
how to create a value proposition in a market that crowded by many product. Example, mie setan, because this is one of the tests from perencanaan bisnis this semester to start a business. And me and my group have decided to make mie setan, and we have tried to make the food and the result. We all agree that the test is delicious. But the next question is how to market it in market that have many competitors. I mean, is it still a room to enter in the market like that? And how? Thank you.
Okay. How the second question is how to market mie setan. What is the first question? Police, you can repeat the Police can help you. Can help me to repeat the first question?
I also not clear for the first question. Okay,
no, Muhammad Alif,
yeah. Alif, please you ask once again for the first questions.
The question is it still a room to enter the market that have many product like Miss Setan have many mark, you know.
Yes. Miss Setan is a name of the product.
No,
yeah, but okay, thank you. I understand. Okay, I remember the first question is how to sell the Mi Setan and among the many product, the similar product like Mi, yeah, noodle, right? Yeah, because noodle. Yeah, because it's some maybe one. I remember in Malaysia, a girl eat while she eating Mi noodle, and then some people. Then he asked to other people, do you like me? Do you like me? It means, do you like a noodle, yeah, not me. Yes, actually, your question is, loosely or maybe has a relationship with the creating market and also to compete, yeah, with others. The first is, for example, if you decide to create a new product, for example, Mi Setan, yeah. First, I conclude that you use a specific name. Yeah, I think interesting. Yeah, but Mi Setan maybe will
be very spicy, but
yeah, very spicy maybe because the setan is spicy. Very yeah, very spicy. The setan, yeah. Like setan kober in Jawa Timur. Yeah, because this attribute, yeah, I think this is the true way, the true strategies in the attribute, yeah, and also the name must reflect the attributes, because this is to create a new brand, a new name, yeah, to introduce the product and to others. But if the related to the second question, how to market to get more market share and other, this depend on the acceptability of the customer, right? You need to test, yeah. Yeah, you need to test the consumer, the new consumer. Is there any repeat buying from the consumer? Yeah, and others. Yeah, if you succeed to sell, yeah, to the customer, it indicated by repeat buying, yeah, and more market share. This you will succeed, and you should you must maintain this. This example, for example, that I discussed with Ulis tentang about the jamuran, yeah, because yes. This specific taste and the consumer in my life, yeah, and until now it still exists and with the high scale, yeah, high market shares. And dominate the market around this location, yeah. But I appreciate, especially politics and others, to support the student to create or to make a new business. For example, it can be as a one program in the university to, for example, to make a corporate program like a co-entrepreneur. Co-entrepreneur mean. We invite or we support the student to create a new product and then a new business, and we can make a collaboration with other institutions such as CSR, yeah, for example, with other to support the finance, yeah, to support the process of the business practice. Because one of the indicators of the graduation from the university, especially in the faculty of the business and economics, yeah, is how many the graduation that will to be a entrepreneur, yeah, entrepreneurs, okay.
Especially for management student, right?
Yes, yeah, management because, and economic, yeah. Also only this.
Yeah, because in management student have the special subject that is entrepreneur, and at the this subject the lecturer then ask the student to create some small business then make the business plan to make the business will be success at the future gitu ya. Ya. Jadi di jurusan manajemen itu juga ada tugas dari dosen untuk menyusun business plan Pak Jaka. Ya, business plan dan diharapkan bahwa business plan ini akan mempunyai prospektus gitu ya ke depan menjadi sebuah bisnis yang sustainable gitu ya, yang sustainable. Okay, yeah, maybe other student, please you maybe have the a good question for Pak Jaka.
Can I ask?
Okay, yes. Who is?
Rahma, I'm from.
Oh, Rahma, okay, Rahmawati from management student.
IBF.
Oh, from IBF program. Okay, yes, please, Rahma, time is yours.
In the long run, impact of monopoly is mergers. So, Mr. Jaka, the mergers between local companies, namely Gojek and Tokopedia, became Goto. They create something. But when I see on social media, on Twitter or Instagram, people are still interested or interesting in Shopee. So what's wrong with our society and how to attract customer to move to the to move from Shopee to Goto? Thank you.
Oh yes. Okay, monggo Pak Jaka.
Yeah, Shopee and Goto. I think Shopee is still market leader now, right?
Yeah. Market leader at the marketplace for the marketplace. For yes.
Yeah, and among the similar business, yeah. But maybe because your question is about the phenomena, yeah, the phenomena effect in the industry is like Shopee and others. We can understand, yeah, or we can see the phenomena based on the motivation, yeah, the motivation of the merger between. One and others business and also maybe our acquisition. Yeah, for example, when the owner want to sell, yeah, or the other one business want to make an acquisition with others or merge between and others, usually they consider next time. They consider the long time next time, for example, because for example, now, if the investor or the owner of the one business is, for example, want to getting, for example, income only, so their perspective is short run, only short run. This is the typical of the investor in maybe in developing countries, including Indonesia, for example. So, for example, if we a person or group of people have a business, yeah, and that is success for the 2 or 3 or 5 years, and then if the other investor want to buy, yeah, and then they for example they offer a very high price, then the owner will sell because this is the perspective is short run. Why? What is the motivation of the investor, for example? Yeah, because they want to invest their money, their extra money, and they concern with the long time, next long time situation, not long time income perspective and others. For example, in the banking, for example, Bukopin, maybe 3 or 4 months ago, the situation of the bank Bukopin, and now the investment from the South Korea make an acquisition and buy more stocks, number of stocks from the Indonesian investor. Yeah, maybe the Indonesian investor say that, or maybe they price, or they maybe they happy with the high money, yeah, the price now. But how about next 5 or 10 years? Yeah, this is different. Yeah, because this different perspective, this is a different motivation. Yeah, I hope our Indonesian, for example, investor or maybe will maintain their business as long as possible and So many business, or especially a high business in Indonesia, is not a foreigner investor owner, but local or Indonesian investor. Yeah. So there is no capital outflow, yeah, because capital outflow will keep or will make depreciation for the our currency. Yeah. At least this. Okay, that's my answer. Pulidis and Rahma.
Yeah, okay. Thank you very much, Pak Jaka, and also for the student that already give the question for Pak Jaka. Maybe another student will continue this question, because I think this is a very very interesting to us to analyze this about the business some slight unicorn Indonesia, yeah, related to the information that we got at the internet, Pak Jaka.
Yes.
This is the new phenomenon that business some slight unicorn, for example Gojek and so on, yeah. The information that we got from the internet is that who gets more profits in this business, only a few people get huge of profits and then now become the new rich club in Indonesia, but not for the grassroots people, for example Gojek pelaksana di lapangan itu nggak dapat untung banyak gitu Pak, semacam tetapi di apa yang paling dapat itu adalah orang-orang bos-bosnya saja gitu. Does this business is a good to Indonesia? Jadi Gojeknya kasihan Pak itu ya.
Jadi
yang di lapangan dia justru sering ditekan sama bos-bos yang di atas itu karena apa harus punya deposit ini dan sebagainya tuh ya, kadang bahkan keuntungan yang diterima juga sangat kecil dari grassroots-nya gitu ya. Related to your opinion, does this business is very good for Indonesia?
Yeah, my opinion is regarding the business, especially we have a topic that's very interesting. This is ethical, yeah, ethical business.
Ethical business ethic
must plays an important role in the not in the theory only, but in the practice. And who will maintain this? Who will protect? Yeah, the country. Yeah, for example. So many country, or maybe if we have a culture, yeah, culture or budaya, yeah, culture, and this is better. Yeah, but maybe the country should protect the people in the. Poor people in the many people that with a low income, yeah, in the business. For example, yeah, this bullet is mentioned about the Gojek.
Yeah.
But try to understand the general or the common business. For example, in the public, yeah, the manufacturing.
Mm-hmm.
How much? What's the level of the labor income, the wage, for example? Yeah, and we can compare with the owner. We can compare the capital owners, the capital, the stockholders. This is incomparable because in Indonesia, usually the labor is only get less than 20% of the total value added, the total benefit in the business.
Yes.
Yeah, it is like, it's also the similar with the big or in the whole business of the Gojek, for example. Yeah, this is not only the riders, but also the investors, the owners, and others. Yeah, this is almost the same. So we need a rule, yeah, or act, yeah, to protect the. Yeah, I hear the many countries, other countries also has a rule or acts, yeah, to protect. For example, to make the minimum wage is one of the policy, yeah, our policy to protect the. Labor, for example, but how effective, how far the effectiveness of the activity of the minimum wage, for example, yeah, this not only a business perspective, but macro, social, and also law, yeah, and okay,
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes. Oh, thank you, Pak Joko, for your explanation. Yeah. I will invite another student. Yeah. I invite from the IMAP student. Yeah. Please, maybe you have the specific or good question for Pak Jaka. Hello, IMAP students. Yeah. Okay, maybe I invite for the Zafran Hanif. Hello, Zafran. You still connect with internet in our discussion today? Hello, Zafran. Oh, yeah. Galih Rakasiwi. Yes.
Galih Rakasiwi.
Yes.
Yes, the name is Galih Rakasiwi.
Yeah, Galih Rakasiwi, a son for no. This is the bintang film from Gita Cinta di Resema,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, Rano and
Yesi Guzman. Okay,
very
Galih. Galih Rakasiwi, you still join with this class?
Iya, yeah, Bu, ada Bu.
Okay, yes. Okay, yeah. You can use the Indonesian bahasa to ask to the Pak Jaka, please. Bisa pakai bahasa Indonesia aja, Li. Mungkin ada pertanyaan dari Galih untuk Pak Jaka, silakan. Halo, Li.
Hmm? Iya, Bu.
Ya.
Lagi nyusun kata-kata.
Oh, nyusun kata-kata ya.
Apa ya? Mungkin
dari manajemen ya?
Iya, dari manajemen, Ibu.
Yes. Ya, saya kira kamu sudah sering berdiskusi dengan Bapak Ibu dosen di kelas soal bisnis ya. Okay, bisa ditanyakan di Pak Jaka hari ini. Silakan.
Yang mau saya tanyakan yaitu apa ya? Di saat misal saya mau bikin bisnis coffee shop gitu. Nah, itu kan sudah marak dan banyak di luar sana. Gimana sih cara kita untuk menemukan kayak istilahnya ciri khas tersendiri dan membuat orang itu bisa datang ke tempat kita gitu sih. Apa yang bisa menjadi sebuah pembeda gitu, Bu?
Oke, yes. Ya. Monggo Pak Jaka.
Ya. Galih, terima kasih.
Galih, terima kasih.
Galih ini asli mana, Galih? Kalau saya pengen ngobrol-ngobrol dengan Galih.
Saya dari Tegal, Pak.
Tegal.
Oh, ngapa sih the best ini, Pak?
Ya. Anda lahir tahun berapa?
Saya lahir tahun 2001, Pak.
2001. Oh, berarti orang tua ya, kira-kira umur berapa sekarang?
Sekarang sudah 50-an. Film Rano Karno, Pak, saya
tahu. Nah, mau saya mau tanya. Kamu... Padahal lahirnya tahun berapa tadi?
2001, Pak.
2001 itu kan 20 tahun setelah filmnya Rano Karno itu.
Iya, Pak.
Kamu tahu juga film-filmnya Galih Rakasiwi itu?
Pernah lihat sekilas sih, Pak.
Oh, harus nonton full itu supaya kamu lebih biar, nyaman, lebih bangga.
Biar dengan... involve ya, Pak, ya. Biar
iya, Galih. Itu karena filmnya bagus itu menurut saya.
Dulu pajak nonton terus tuh.
Iya, berulang-ulang itu.
Berulang-ulang ya, Pak ya.
Iya.
Mesti kesetan sama peran perempuan.
Iya, kan lagu-lagunya ya, kan bagus-bagus juga itu.
Iya.
Ya, Galih tadi pertanyaannya sebenarnya memang ya hampir-hampir sama ya Galih tadi. Itu intinya kan bagaimana menciptakan pembeda ya, diferensiasi ya. Kalau kita ingin buat coffee shop itu ya, tetapi sebenarnya kan yang namanya ide pembeda itu ya ada terus toh sebenarnya, bisa kita ciptakan terus ya, tergantung kita bagaimana kita bisa memahami lingkungan ya, maka perlunya kita kemudian sering touring ya. Kita kadang-kadang touring itu selain memberikan satu fresh ya, satu penyegaran pada kita punya wawasan baru, kita tahu oh kalau di sana begini, di sini begini gitu ya. Nah, kemudian bisa kita bawa ke tempat kita gitu ya. Cara-cara yang berbeda itu bisa, desain yang berbeda itu juga bisa. Karena misalkan ada pertanyaan begini, pertanyaan pentingnya kan begini, how consumer value the product ya. Bagaimana sebenarnya konsumen itu menilai sebuah produk yang kita jual? Ya, kita bisa bedakan, kan pembeda itu tidak harus melekat pada produknya seperti yang kita pikirkan tadi ya, kita dalam teori. Tetapi bisa jadi konsumen itu produknya sama, tetapi memiliki nilai lebih dari aspek-aspek yang lain tadi ya. Aspek lokasi, aspek waktu, ya, aspek kemasan, aspek, dan macam-macam banyak sekali. Nah, itu yang termasuk juga yang kedua adalah memang orang jualan sekarang juga harus membidik pasarnya. Pasar yang kita bidik itu pasar yang bawah, menengah, atau tinggi. Kalau yang kita bidik pasar bawah, Anda mesti jualan sesuatu harus murah. Faktor lain tidak begitu penting, karena ini bicara harga. Tapi kalau menengah, itu sudah mulai meningkat ya. Sudah mulai meningkat, kemudian harga mungkin agak bisa lebih mahal sedikit, tapi faktor-faktor lain harus dipertimbangkan ya, faktor tempat, faktor nyaman, gitu. Tapi kalau Anda membidik pasar yang lebih tinggi lagi, itu sangat beda sekali, ya, sangat berbeda. Ya, karena yang bernilai di situ adalah tentang pengakuan, ya, aktualisasi diri seorang, ya, dan itu harus dibangun dimulai dari image ya brand. Tentang harga itu boleh saya katakan di situ harus mahal. Ya, harus mahal karena mahal itulah kemudian yang punya efek dua hal. Bagi penjual memang kemahalan itu dijadikan dasar untuk melakukan pelayanan dan lain-lain. Bagi konsumen mahal itu adalah pengakuan. Jadi jangan dikira bahwa semua orang cari itu sesuatu yang murah, enggak. Ada orang yang malu ketika membeli sesuatu itu murah. Dia kalau beli harus mahal. Ya, karena ini masalah positioning. Nah, contoh saya berikan contoh. Artikel-artikel yang berkembang sekarang ini tentang sebuah produk tertentu, itu ternyata faktor penentu larisnya itu adalah simbolisme. Ya, ini simbolisme. Jadi simbolisme itu adalah ya simbol pengakuan gitu ya. Makanya kalau di maskapai pesawat, di hotel, kemudian di tempat bank dan sebagainya, itu kan memang ada ya spesifik. Nah, tinggal Anda misalkan mau yang mana ini, bawah, menengah, atau ini harus tentukan dulu. Nah, baru di situlah semakin tinggi yang tadi saya katakan tadi, tentu konsumennya menjadi memang lebih sedikit. Bukan berarti kemudian profitnya rendah ya, tapi penjualnya juga mungkin relatif lebih sedikit, sehingga persaingan lebih longgar, tidak seperti yang paling bawah lah kira-kira gitu. Atau jangan-jangan justru yang menengah itu yang paling banyak persaingnya. Itu perlu diamati, mengamati hal-hal semacam itu penting ya, karena ya tadi kalau Anda ingin membuka coffee shop itu yang model-model tertentu ya, itu ya memang tadi pastikan dulu market share yang akan dilayani ya mana, dan coba membuat satu nilai ya, nilai-nilai yang cocok ya, yang cocok dan itu dicari oleh konsumen itu ya, nilai-nilai yang spesifik ya itu. Saya kira itu Bu Lilis.
Ya, oke. Thank you. Thank you very much for the explanation, Pak Jaka. Okay, the last question I will offering to siapa ini ya? Abdul. The last question I will offering to Abdullah Yusron. Okay, Abdullah, you still join with our class today?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah, okay. The last question from you to Pak Jaka. Maybe you have the unique question and maybe difficult question.
But maybe how far difficult question? I just want to ask about one term that okay. The doctor mentioned before about equi-marginal thing. Can you explain more about what exactly equi-marginal thing?
Sorry? Equi-marginal
thing, I think you say that before.
Marginal thing, what you mean?
Jadi di slide tadi kan ada, kalau nggak salah, equi-marginal, kalau nggak salah. Equi-marginal.
Bisa ditayangin lagi, Pak Jaka? You can show the slides, yes.
Okay. Sebentar.
Tadi di awal-awal kalau nggak salah.
At the beginning of slide or the final of slide?
Equimarginal.
Kalau nggak salah tadi equimarginal.
Equimarginal, marginal, marginal cost or marginal.
Which one?
Again. Next. No.
Next. Okay.
Next. Masih next.
Next. Next. Okay.
Masih next. Ah, itu. Yang itu. Equi-marginal thinking.
Oh, yeah. Yes.
Oh, equi-marginal thinking.
Yeah. Equi-marginal, equi mean same. Equivalent. Equivalent marginal between marginal revenue and marginal cost.
Yeah.
This is the rule in profit maximization, yeah, in micro and also managerial, that marginal the prerequisite for the profit maximum is marginal revenue equal with marginal cost. So this is equi marginal thinking, yeah. Equivalent marginal.
Oh, so it's the same thing with equivalent.
Yeah, equivalent.
Oh, okay. Thank you.
Thank you. Okay.
Yeah, marginal revenue equal with marginal cost is the condition that have to reach by the company to have the maximum profit, right, Pak Jaka?
Mm-hmm. Yes. This one.
Okay. Yeah. For all market, I think this condition, yeah. Not only for perfect competition, but also in another market.
Another market, yes.
Yes.
But this is only theory. In fact, I think in fact it's difficult to find which point that the MR equal to MC. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, because theory is guidance. Yeah. Theory is a way, a direction.
Okay. Yeah. So how can the company can reach the maximum profit if this is only just in the theory also?
Yeah, actually the theory, economic theory, is different with accounting theory, I think. Yeah. For example, actually theory gave us a sense, for manager also there's a sense to make a decision, a best decision, effective decision and efficient decision, but mathematically we can calculate. Yeah, mathematically we can calculate the marginal revenue, marginal cost.
Yeah.
For example, and then we can compare. It's really mathematical. But in practice, marginal cost and marginal revenue
It is difficult to find the marginal cost equal with marginal revenue
practice, yeah. But this is the direction, the guidance to, for example, in a certain situation, for example, how or when the manager should improve or increase the margin cost, or to reduce the cost, or which opportunity to the situation to increase the price, it's when the marginal revenue will increase and others.
Okay. Thank you very much, Pak Jaka. I already told to the student that maximum profit is the ideal conditions for the company, but it is not easy to reach this condition. Not only hard to catch, but I think this is impossible. to catch this condition at the marginal cost equal with marginal revenue. But this theory is a guidance for the management when management in a process of decision making. In what area the manager have to work? So the company still get the profits, because as long as the company still get a profit, it means that the company in condition of efficient. It is right also not, Pak Jaka?
Yes, but I can mention the other perspective, Police, that not all the firm or business try to get a maximum profit, because maybe
I think it is very hard to catch this.
Yeah, the more important maybe is sustainability. How to sustain the business? For example, many international business until now, for example, enters to the more than 100 years old. For example, in Indonesia, in Jogja, for example, Mirota is more than 50 years old and others. To maintain
Mirota
the sustainability.
Mirota supermarket, right?
Yeah,
not Mirota batik, not Mirota
bakery. And others, IWS, for example, and others. Yeah. They can sustain for the long time because they don't stay at the maximum profit, actually.
Yes. But only small profit, I think, because the price in Mirota is cheaper than others.
Yes.
Okay. Yeah, thank you, Pak Jaka. Okay, guys, I think our time is over because now at the 3 p.m., related to the our schedule, our class today start from 1 to 3 p.m. So we already 2 hours for discussion with Mr. Jaka Sriyana, understanding about market structure. But there are many type of question that's asked by the student. It is a very good for our lesson today. And the point here that Pak Jaka said that now many companies not only focusing on at the maximum profit or large profits, but the focus of the company is to get a sustainability at the future, like Mirota Campus, not Mirota Bakery and Mirota Batik, Mirota Godian, Mirota Campus, I think sell the product with the cheapest price when we compare with others. The goals of this decision making is a sustainability to the future. Okay. Yes. Okay. Thank you very much for this discussion, Pak Jaka, and I think this is a very very important to the student, and valuable information, valuable discussion to make more understanding related to the business in Indonesia and also global economic now. Okay, guys, let's close our discussion today by alhamdulillah together.
Alhamdulillah. Thank you all.
Thank you for
the participants, the students from the ITF and Muhammadiyah and Fulilis.
Regular students. I will close by assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Thank you,
Dr.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.